Let me start this video with a very crazy fact. Approximately 39.5% of men and women will be diagnosed with cancer at some point during their lifetimes. Cancer is unfortunately a tremendously common disease in our society. It's so common that we just accept the fact that it's there, that it's everywhere. But do you know where cancer actually comes from? Do you know how and when it starts?
Quick warning, turns out I'm super dumb and I did not realize my laptop was in the shot, so you're basically gonna be seeing my laptop for the whole video. Sorry about that.
If I had to sum it up in just one word, the answer would be mutations. Life is thought to have emerged from the combination of different compounds, such as hydrogen, nitrogen, carbon, oxygen. And what's interesting is that we went from having a bunch of random elements to this, and this, and this, and even this. And believe it or not, all forms of life share a same common ancestor. And I know it sounds wonderful, almost magical, like, wow, Mother Nature is so clever. But the saddest part is that we went from this to this by freaking accident. It has all been a combination of entirely random events that have been powered by natural selection. And these random events are what we call mutations. Mutations are what made the polar bear switch from brown to white when it was in snow because it allowed it to survive better. Or what made organs such as the lung and the heart to ever come up. And you know those people that can do these weird things with their tongues? That's also a mutation. A pretty useless one, but still a mutation. In other words, mutations are what drive evolution and is what has led us to where we are now. It has helped not only in the existence of different species, but also is responsible for unique traits that are different between each and all of us, and that may or may not confer a better chance of survival. However, contrary to what it may seem, mutations are not driven by this divine force that fights for the sake of evolution. They're entirely random events that can be either positive or detrimental for a species, or just don't have any effect at all. Take lactose tolerance, for example. Grown adults are not really supposed to be drinking breast milk. In fact, we're the only species that does that. That's why a percentage of the population is lactose intolerant. But lactose tolerance occurred in the UK as a consequence of heavy cattle activity. And as this meant more nurturing possibilities for its inhabitants, it's a mutation that stayed. So it was a positive mutation. On the other hand, any genetic disease such as cystic fibrosis or familial hypercholesterolemia, Why did I choose this example? Are also consequences of mutations, and they're obviously not good. They're not beneficial. And the fact that some people can touch the tip of their nose with the tip of their tongue is also a mutation. And it's again not useless at all. Unless there comes a day when we're invaded by zombies and the only people that can survive are those that can touch their nose with their tongues. We'll have to see. Okay, so what does any of this have to do with cancer? Aside from all the evident mutations, those we can see, there are thousands of mutations going on in your cells every hour. And why do these occur? Long story short, every time your cells divide, the entire DNA needs to be copied and pasted. Remember, your entire DNA is stored in each and every one of your cells. And you have billions of those. Trillions. And the DNA is made of 3 billion base pairs, and these base pairs are represented by 4 letters. This replication is carried out by our old friend, the DNA polymerase. But of course, nobody's perfect. Imagine having to transcribe 3 billion letters one by one. Even if you tried your absolute hardest, chances are you would make a mistake. And if this is something you do multiple times a day, you're eventually going to mess up. So basically, the DNA polymerase does mess it up sometimes. And this can mean that if one letter is changed, just as it can happen with words, the entire code can maybe no longer make sense. But now let me ask you something. Do you think that after billions, well not billions, but millions of years of evolution, your cells don't know that? Girl, they're expecting it. The fact that the polymerase screws up does not necessarily mean that it will have a consequence, because in every division cycle, cells have what we call checkpoints. Just like they did in Checkpoint Charlie in 20th century Berlin, little soldiers will make sure that this dividing cell meets all the requirements to go to the next phase. Well, actually, that doesn't have anything to do with Checkpoint Charlie, but you know what I mean. And what if they don't? What if they don't meet all of these requirements? Then they can either be given a second chance to fix their mutations, or they are condemned to a terrible fate, in which they run the risk of becoming a mutant cell. But as we said, nobody's perfect, and these little soldiers are allowed to make mistakes as well. But if they do and they let a dividing cell get away with mutations, that's when things can start to get ugly. Cancer cells basically do what our cells normally don't do. Healthy cells divide just when they have to, and they die when they're too old. By definition, cancer starts when a mutated cell goes undetected and does not repair itself. This cell can now possibly divide indefinite amounts of time, until these cells form what we call a tumor. As I'm sure you have heard, tumors are not necessarily and strictly bad. Tumors are really bad when they have the ability to invade neighboring tissues, or even worse, metastasize, which means they manage to leave the area they're trapped in, make it to the bloodstream, and eventually go to other places in the body where they do what they do best, which is growing uncontrollably. What about benign tumors? How can something like that ever not be bad? Well, these tumors lack the ability to spread throughout the body, and that's why if detected early, they can be removed and they normally don't grow back. So far you've understood what mutations are, how these happen all the freaking time and can be positive, negative, or not have an effect at all, and how these can lead to cells growing uncontrollably, and this can lead to the formation of tumors. But let's go back to the title of this video. How does cancer start? Where do these mutations come from? As I said, they normally happen during cell division. Other than that, many different factors may play a role as well, such as age, sex, genetic constitution, immune system function, metabolism, hormone levels, nutrition, cultural environment, and even workplace. Some environmental factors, such as tobacco smoke or sunlight, can increase the chances of getting a mutation and therefore cancer. Yes, you can get skin cancer from the sun. It's a very real thing. I did an entire video on how UV rays can have such an effect, so you better watch it, and I hope you're wearing your sunscreen. And lastly, there are some inherited traits that can enhance the chance of getting cancer, although these are more rare. But they're still there. Remember when Angelina Jolie got her breast removed because she had a family history of breast cancer? This is often related to a mutation in the very well-known BRCA2 gene, which is heavily associated with breast cancer. Another example is the protein P53 that is involved in the process of making sure that cells don't grow uncontrollably. And guess what protein is mutated in a lot of types of cancers? You guessed it, P53. So yes, there are certain things that can increase the chances of you getting... How many times am I gonna say the word chances? Okay, that can... increase the chances of you getting cancer. That's no news for you guys. And food is one of those factors as well. If you haven't been living under a rock, you must remember the whole the red meat causes cancer scandal. But for the sake of the simplicity of this video, I won't go in much detail regarding this topic. However, if you're curious whether certain substances or foods can give us cancer and how, make sure to subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for the next video, which will be a part of this cancer series. In any case, radiation, tobacco, the sun are substances that, if we're exposed to them more often than we should, can mess up your DNA. And your DNA, I think you know now, is already too busy minding its own business. It does not need anybody or anything messing up with it, so you better keep that in mind. Have you ever wondered why the older we get, the higher the chance... No, not the word chances again. Have you ever wondered why the older we get, the higher the incidence of cancer is? The median age of diagnosis is 66 years old, and the median age of death is 72 years old. The mutations both due to mistakes during replication and the factors that we have just described might build up. And once a cell has an enabling mutation, it is likely that they divide faster and it can now accumulate more and more mutations, and it will have a harder time trying to fix these mutations. And we also need to consider that the older we get, the less effective some of the checkpoints may be, and some mistakes may slip by, in a combination with a possibly immune system that may have a harder time being aware that there are some cancerous cells going around. If you wonder why there will ever be a cure to cancer, make sure to watch this video in which I talk about 9 reasons why there will never really be a cure for cancer. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you like and enjoy this type of conversations, and do let me know down below in the comments which topic you would like me to talk about in the next video. Bye! By definition, cancer starts when a mutated cell... By definition, a mutated cell... Are you kidding me?